हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर सुप्रिया सवगुले, वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डी आर के कॉलेज ऑफ कॉमर्स कोल्हापुर। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इन ब्रीफ द इंट्रोडक्शन टू द इनकम टैक्स, दैट इज डायरेक्ट टैक्स। नाउ इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू यूज टी पैक मॉडल, टी फॉर टेक्नोलॉजिकल नॉलेज, पी फॉर पेडागॉजिकल नॉलेज एंड सी फॉर कंटेंट नॉलेज। So by this model, you are going to learn in a better manner than earlier. So friends, what will be the learning outcome after this course lecture? Then audio and video presentation will help to learn in a better manner than the direct. Student will be able to evaluate the assessment process of tax in a better way, and it will also increase the awareness about tax liability and the strong sense of liability towards the organization and its tax responsibility. Now these are the contents which we are going to discuss in today's lecture. First one is income tax, the concept of income, concept of direct tax as well as indirect tax, direct tax as a income tax, assessment year and previous year, and some tax labs. So what is mean by income tax? A tax is a compulsory financial charge or some other type of levy imposed upon a taxpayer by a government organization in order to fund various public expenditure. Friends, we know that public expenditure is useful for development of society, and the government is not running any business venture in a commercial way, though public companies are there, public entities are there, but as a businessman runs his business with the motto of profit maximization, government does not. So how government collects the revenue for public expenditure? Then government collects the expenditure, the revenue for the purpose, for by the way of collection of the taxes. There are two ways of collection of taxes. First one is direct tax and second one is indirect tax. Before that, first we should clear out our concept of income. Income may be received in cash or kind. Income received in kind is to be valued as per rules prescribed, and if there is no specific direction regarding valuation in the act or rules, it may be valued at a market price. So income may be in cash or in kind. Income may be from a temporary source or a permanent source. Income also includes negative income, that is loss. There is no difference between income received in lump sum or in installment. The Act does not make any difference between legal or illegal income. Same income cannot be taxed twice. Now we should understand the difference between direct tax and indirect tax. Direct tax is that tax which incidents and impact fall on the same person, on single person, whereas the tax which incidents and impact fall on two different persons, that is called as indirect tax. Assessee himself bears such taxes and it is levied on income, that is called as direct tax, whereas the tax is recovered from the assessee who passes such burden to another person, that is called as indirect tax. The example of direct tax is income tax, and the example of indirect tax is GST, that is levied on goods and services. It is regressive in nature, whereas direct tax is progressive in nature. Higher the income, higher the tax. Now we should know in which year or for which year's income is going to be taxed. So the previous year is called as income year, and that income is earned, that year is called as previous year. Previous year is the preceding year of the assessment year. Here is the difference between assessment year and the previous year. Point to remember is that previous year is the income earning year, whereas assessment year is the taxation year. Now this is the format, a basic format for computation of total income for the assessment year. Whatever the current assessment year, that is going to be recorded here. Then there are five heads of income. First one is salary, second one is house property, third one is business and profession, fourth one is capital gain, and the last one is not fitting in the above criteria, that is income from other sources. All are calculated, total, that is called as gross total income, and deduction under section 80C to 80U is applied, and then remaining amount is called as total income for the purpose of taxation. Now friends, we should know some of the basic concepts. Tax planning, it is a way to reduce tax liability by taking full advantages provided by the Act through various exemptions, reductions, rebates and relief. Whereas tax evasion is the illegal way to reduce tax liability by deliberately suppressing income or sale or by increasing expenses. Tax avoidance and tax management are also important two concepts. Tax avoidance is an exercise by which the assessee legally takes advantages of loopholes in the Act, whereas tax management is the process of complying with the provisions of the law. It is a continuous approach which is concerned with past rectification, revision, and present and future also. Now these are the current tax rates for the assessment year 2019-20 applied for individual, Hindu undivided family, association of persons, body of individuals, artificial juridical person born on or after 2nd April 1959 or non-resident individual. So in this lecture, the principles applied for multimedia learning are coherence, narration, segmenting, voice, personalization, embodiment, signaling. I hope this presentation will be helpful for understanding direct tax concept. Thank you.